Hello all, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install latest version of PyCharm. So you're going to use the latest version of PyCharm version 2024.2. So now do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues, you can always comment. I'm also on Instagram now, so you can ask all of your questions right over there. I'll definitely going to try to help you. So now to install PyCharm, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and then you need to search over here PyCharm download and hit enter. So that going to show you this www.jetbrains.com as the first search result. So to click on this download PyCharm, and it's going to redirect to the official site of PyCharm. So this link, this JetBrains.com link, I'm going to provide right in your description, so you can directly use that link to land over here. Once you are here, you'll be able to see that it is available for Windows, macOS and Linux, right? So you need to just simply switch to this all tab depending upon what operating system you are using. So now I am going to switch to Windows tab, and I'm going to download the community one. So this is professional one. I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to download this PyCharm community edition. So I'm going to click on this download button, and immediately you'll be able to say thank you for downloading PyCharm, and you can see it is actually started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that same PyCharm community 2024.2 is already been downloaded over here, and the file size is 585 MB. So to install, you need to just simply double click on the exe, and it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes, and there you go. So welcome to PyCharm community edition setup. So let's first minimize our download directory, and here you need to just simply click on next. So this is where our PyCharm is going to be installed. So on our C program files, it's going to create a JetBrains folder, and within that it's going to create PyCharm community edition folder over here, and right inside that it's going to, you know, create all the files. So the most important thing is you need to check how much available space you are having. So I am having 123 gigabyte of free space, so it will require about 1.8 gigabyte, so it is sufficient, so I don't need to, you know, do anything. So you need to just simply check whether you have the available space properly, and then you need to click on next. So here you'll see under installation options lot of checkboxes. So I'll start with checking this PyCharm community edition. So it's going to create a desktop shortcut, so I want to create a desktop shortcut. Similarly, I'll also like to check this add open folder as project. So what happens is any folder that are lying probably on your desktop, if you just simply right click, it's going to additionally show this option called open folder as project. Alright, so that's really helpful, I must say. So always check that. Along with that, I'll also check this .py. .py basically means all Python files. It's going to create one associations with PyCharm. So it's going to open this .py file with PyCharm. And I'm going to also select this add bin folder to path. So you need to restart your system. This is very important. You know, don't forget to check this, and then you need to click on next. So it's going to create a JetBrains folder. Totally fine. Click on install. So you can see our installation is rightly begun, along with desktop shortcut is also created over here. PyCharm Community Edition 2024.2. So now let's wait for a couple of minutes to get it finished installing PyCharm. So by the time it get installed, I'll also like to talk about this channel called Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I'm posting lot of coding related videos. So please do subscribe Geeky Syntax channel. That really motivate me to make more this kind of videos. Along with, if you're interested, you can also subscribe our GeekyScape vlogging channel. So all this channel link I'm going to provide right in your description. And also, if you are having any questions, you can ask me on Instagram. So that link also I'm going to provide. So now let's wait for a couple of minutes. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our PyCharm community edition is successfully installed, and it is telling whether you'd like to reboot your system now or you'd like to manually reboot later. So I'll always recommend you to reboot your system now. So just simply check this reboot now option and click on finish to reboot your system. So, you know, let's do it, and after that again come back to this video. So welcome back. So after successfully rebooting your system, we'll be again landed to our desktop, and here is our PyCharm community edition desktop shortcut. So let's just simply double click on it to start launching our PyCharm community, and it has rightly started launching. and it has rightly launched. So here it is telling whether like to import all settings from Visual Studio Code. So again, on my previous videos, I have made a detailed video about Visual Studio Code. So if you have previously installed Visual Studio Code, you can always import all the settings, you know, just click of a button, or else you can just follow this video. So you can just simply click on skip import and, you know, let's start everything fresh. So welcome to PyCharm. So let's click on this new project. So it's going to show you this new project window. Here you need to provide your project name. So let's give the project name as, you know, Hello World project, and it's going to create under this folder. So it's going to, you know, create a PyCharm projects folder on our user directory, and within there it's going to, you know, create this folder. So now everything is properly fine. It's going to download the latest version of Python, which is 3.12.5. if you want to manually install Python, so that also you can do. I have made a little video about that as well. So for now, just simply click on create. So it's going to start creating your Python project. So it's going to download your Python also. You need to have active internet connection. You can see it is fetching all the files and then going to install it. So again, this entire process will take some time, about, you know, 3 to 4 minutes, I would say. So let's wait for some time, and then, you know, I'm going to again come back to this video. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our Hello World project is successfully opened within our PyCharm community 2024.2 version. So let's first maximize it. So this is about what's new in the latest version of PyCharm. You can always read this documentation, it's really helpful. For now, you know, let's go to this folder, right click and hover over new and click on file. Python file over here. So that going to show you this new Python file, you know, window. So here you need to select what type of file you want to create. It's going to be a simple Python file. If it is for testing, you can do that, and all these different things you can do. It will be a simple Python file. I'll name this file name as main.py, and I'm going to just double click on this Python file, and it's going to create main.py file over here. You can see it is properly created. So let's print something. So let's print hello. So hello, you know, after writing this, let's click on the run button, and you can see the output coming on our console. So in this way, you can easily install latest version of PyCharm and Windows operating system. You can start, you know, working on all the assignments that you have probably got from your school or college. If you are facing any issues, you can always ask me on Instagram. And with screenshots and everything, I'm definitely going to help you. Along with, you can also comment whether these videos are really helping you or not. Alright, and also don't forget to subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel along with Geeky Skip blogging channel. So that's going to really motivate me to make these similar kind of videos. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.